Welcome to my super duper early May 2018 calendar.
Again.
Yep. So now I am visiting my family for the summer, and here is my brogy.
And they probably don't want to listen to me.
And my sister, who's probably not going to respond. And so this is our, awesome, or my awesome, I mean, I say our because we're here, so, but it actually is mine, but I don't like to take pride for stuff when I'm not the only one here. This is my May 2018 calendar, which is super early because, as you well know, this is June and, well, when we're recording this, there's only 10 days left in June, and this is my May calendar.
That one's on the same side as the next calendar, I think.
What?
The month name.
I don't know.
This one, well, the 7th would be safer.
Oh. So yeah. But then the mouse isn't gonna show up because of how I edit this. This is just gonna be one big picture. So he's talking about the Inside Out calendar, but that's January. January is not next to... July is next to this month, which is what we still haven't done yet. But here is my awesome May 2018 calendar, 1.5 months late. The Chronicles of Narnia 2, Prince Caspian.
Don't scare others.
So, it is May. You like May, don't you? I just realized something. I forgot to bring the last month theme text upward, so, Well, that's a problem, because if I send this backward, I'll accidentally bring up next month's theme text.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Yeah, that's going to be depressing, but we'll just...
No next month theme.
We can't know next month theme yet. So this is May 2018, and, well, this marks the 10th... May 2018 marks the 10th anniversary of the second Narnia movie.
It is.
Actually, June 2018 marked the 10th anniversary of WALL-E, which we saw the same year with the Summer with Dad. So, Narnia 2 came to theaters in May, and we ended up seeing it with our dad in the $2 theater in Kansas.
That was a long time ago.
You remember it?
What one?
The second Narnia.
That one.
Yep. And so, you know... May is awesome. Usually I do a very awesome theme for May. And so, you know, I couldn't think of any, like, super spectacular thing, but I really do like the Narnia series, so I decided that even though it's not... I mean, actually, it probably is 5-star, but it's not, like, 6-star, maybe. I don't know. It's pretty high, though. It's, like... And so, yeah. One of the reasons that this was so late is because I wanted to watch the movie... Again, before I got pictures for it, because I just wanted to watch it, and when I go through and get pictures, you know, I...
We haven't watched in years.
I watched it, so what happened is I checked it out, and, I checked it out, like, the end of April. It came in, but unfortunately, I wanted to see the Infinity War that weekend, and so I just wasn't... I just wasn't able to find time because I wanted to enjoy this as its own separate thing and not have to have it compete with Infinity War. So, I had to return it. I had to return it before I watched it, and so I didn't get any pictures for my calendar. And then I did check it out again, finally watched it, finally got pictures, but by then it was halfway through the month and I was busy with finals. And then, you know, and then... I came to visit my family at the end of the month, and, you know, it was just, like, so busy that... And then I was reading Wings of Fire and everything, which, you know, basically took up all my free time other than finals. And, yeah. Yeah, and then that's just how it happened. So I wasn't able to finish this calendar right away, and... Then I got to my family's, and then, you know, a 130-mile bike ride, and, yeah, a lot of excuses, and...
Wasn't the last one we did on Christmas?
We did Coco. We did Coco together. So when we did that, I was unfortunately unable to do this calendar until, well, and then, you know, internet's bad, so it took a long time to get the next month theme picture and everything. And
it will take a long time to get this put on.
Actually, I did check the CD out from the library, and I have the music ready to go so I can edit it, the music into it. So yeah, I have the music. But yeah, we saw this in theaters in 2018 in the $2 theater, and it was awesome.
It was there.
Yeah. I mean, 2008.
Oh, that was 10 years ago.
And so it was an awesome movie, and, you know, when I watched it a second time, I mean, it wasn't my second time, it was probably my 10th time or something. For some reason, we haven't watched it 100 times, like, we maybe the first Narnia. But we've seen this movie a few times, I guess, and, yeah, I was, like, watching it, and it was just, like, I think it was really well done. Don't you? Like, it's a real movie.
10 years younger than...
Yeah, so this is a real movie, Narnia is, and so I think it was awesome, and it's sad that the Silver Chair, that hopefully they don't recast Aslan, because, you know, that would just be depressing, and that might be the one thing. And, so yeah, Narnia is a really great movie. It's a little bit different from the book, but then the book was actually sort of short, if you think about it, other than like a long thing about Prince Caspian, which they sort of summed up in a few things with the movie. So it was a quick, like a few minutes in the movie, they summed up the Prince Caspian story, which took up like a third of the book. And then, you know, but then they expanded on it. They added the invasion of the castle. It's been a while since I read the book, but yeah. They brought in quite a few elements into the movie that weren't in the book, but it still ended up pretty good, and it sort of built along the characters from the first one, and, you know, and when I was looking for pictures or something, or no, I looked up Edmund or something. Wait, no, did I look up Edmund or... I looked up something, and it showed a picture from Edmund in the second movie, and there was words next to it in the picture or whatever that said bad boy, but it was from the second movie, and Edmund... is probably one of the least bad boys in the second Narnia. He was a bad boy in the first Narnia, not the second. Right? Okay, so this is probably weird tangents. But, okay, so it's been a while since I did the first Narnia calendar, and I just decided to be spontaneous when doing the second, because, you know, what else could I do? And it just seemed exciting, and I wanted to watch the second Narnia. And, you know, getting a calendar for it was sort of an excuse. Now, as you can see, it's a follow-up to the first Narnia, which I did in April 2014.
Not long ago, that was about 4 years.
Yeah, so, but then I decided to do the second Narnia. And, as you can see, there's quite a few differences, such as shadows. And you can see here that most of the pictures, they have full screen aspect ratio. That's because I got them off of my mom's DVD, and for some reason my mom likes full screen.
She can see the picture better.
Yeah, she can see the picture better when they cut half the image out. I don't think they're the full screen version of Prince Caspian, because I think that's when they stopped doing full screen. Well, they were ending it about that time. So there was only a widescreen copy to get. So mom can get the bars at the top and bottom of the screen. Which means that you get the full side image, too. So, coming up with the color scheme was a little bit complex. I decided to use... Well, here I used yellow, I mean not yellow, orange, and then here I also used orange. I did a little bit of shadows, and I know that they say that shadows upward are sort of, you know, they use them in horrors usually, but I was like, well, the sun is setting in this horizon. So,
one
here, the sun is pretty much here, I assume. So, or somewhere. It's so, as far as the lighting goes, there's no real sun in the picture, but you know, the sun's about here, I would think. So, the shadows would be pointing upward, I hope. I'm not the best shadow expert and lighting expert. But, okay, so what I was thinking about doing...
We wouldn't be shadows someplace that always might be.
Well, what I was thinking is what color to do. Well, I was thinking about doing this, because there seems to be some blue in it. But, you know, I didn't want just a classical blue background. That just seemed weird. And actually, this does look like a nice background still. But, you know, I just didn't want plain blue. So this actually, I made this with some transparency, so you could see through it to see some of the blue on the other end. But it was sort of yellow, because I felt yellow was more the theme color, although there is some sky here. But, you know, I just didn't want to feel like the typical blue sky, the green grass. I was going to do a lighter blue, but then, you know, when I decided to add this over, I ended up going, I think, for a deeper blue. And so, yeah, and you can see in this poster, there's quite a bit of, yellowish orange and green, which sort of were the same color that they used here. And, you know, it's sort of a grassland, woodsy kind of place, so the green fit really well. And then, I was also thinking this. I think this picture was sort of the biggest inspiration for the colors, I guess. Although I was originally going to do, like, maybe this one. Oh, wow. The ratings. Oh, man, some of the ratings have scary words in them. I'm gonna have to edit that because there were scary words in some of the ratings.
Why were you looking at the ratings?
Because I wanted to see if Mission Impossible 6 was rated yet, because I don't want Mom to have to censor it again. Darkest Minds and Ant-Man 2 were rated this week. And they're both decent.
Sounds fun for you.
That's gonna be... I don't know, how am I gonna edit that? Should I just put advisory warning before that appears, maybe? Advisory warning.
Why can't you take it out?
Because it's super hard to edit that kind of stuff.
It is. Why?
Because you have to separate the sound from the audio, and I can only use a program that means that... that makes it super hard, which means I gotta publish the audio separate and then put it back in, and I have to put a replacement, and... now it isn't gonna be released until, like, July or August.
Oh, well.
If I have to edit like that, it'll probably take till August.
When did it restart? It's 10:31
now. I don't know. But yeah, this is gonna be a problem. But then I was, like, thinking about the other colors. Maybe we can just cut that out. I don't know, this is gonna be hard.
Worth spending much time.
Yeah. So, what I was thinking is that, you know, for the first Narnia calendar, there's also this, where it's, like, this part was a different color than this part. So, I decided that it should be the same way with this one. And also, the shadows are pretty much the same, except going in the opposite direction, or the lighting, you know, it gets darker and then lighter, darker and then lighter. And I decided to keep the line color and the text font black in this one, instead of turning it white, just because white just didn't seem to work. But I decided to use orange hair instead, when this one was red, but then the one below it was orange. Yeah, but orange works well. I wonder what this would look like if I turn it red. No, we shouldn't change it. That would be hard to change. Okay, so the pictures. Here is an awesome poster for Narnia 2.
We saw it a few times.
Yeah. So there's all the characters, and there's Aslan, and then there's Reepicheep.
And all the words.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of words to show that stuff. Here is Prince Caspian saying you're a mouse to Reepicheep, and they don't realize that Reepicheep doesn't realize he's a friend. Thinks he's a foe. Here is the return to the stone table. I don't know how they got the stone table underground, but it's underground. But you know, Aslan has vanished for a while. Yeah, I know. And then here we have the attack on Miraz's castle. The Telmarine castle. And Peter, Susan, and, others are getting ready for battle. Oh yeah, this is thousands of years after the first one, when they're younger, and they, the question is, they vanished for 1,000 years, and Narnia was taken over. That's the plot of the movie, in a way. By Telmarines. And here is, a great shot in the movie. It was just epic looking when they're running to the battle, and I was like, this is an epic scene. When I was watching it last time. Really well done, I think, with the camera and everything. And yeah, it was a really awesome thing. And then here is them at Cair Paravel, the ruins of Cair Paravel. So they're looking and seeing that this is where they used to be king and queens of Narnia. And then here's Lucy walking in the woods in a dream where Aslan wakes up the forest.
What made the colorhood for the calendar?
Sort of. And then here is Peter battling Miraz. I keep thinking Luke for some reason. Maybe it's just because we watched Star Wars the other day.
Luke.
I don't know why. And then here we have Peter and the White Witch. The White Witch is going to return because they want to use her to recover Narnia. And, she was from old Narnia. Why not use a bad guy from old Narnia to restore old Narnia? Well, because she's a bad guy. And, she's evil and she's behind ice. Hopefully if they make the magician's nephew, they keep the actor, The actor. Oh, I forgot. Why did I forget her name? Tilda Swinton or whatever. But I'm talking about the other name.
Oh, there's more than one name.
Okay, let's just skip it.
Take two.
Okay, and then here is Prince Caspian in the badger's home. I forgot the badger's name, too. But I believe the badger is voiced by the actor of Balin. From Hobbit. Ken Scott, I think. Yeah.
Oh.
And they're from the badger's home. And then here is them before Aslan with Lucy and everything. Yeah. And then here's them on a boat thinking of how Narnia has changed in 1,000 years, which was only a year for them, although they grew much more than a year old or between the Narnia movies. And then here is them back where it's like, I left my new torch in Narnia or something. I probably did a terrible impression of Edmund. And then here's the guy who is like, what? Yeah. So that's the way it is. Last month theme, I am going to be very weird. So, last month theme is, I'm gonna have to send this backwards, so, yeah. Curtis. Send backwards. Thor Ragnarok, Thor 3. Yeah. Mm. You liked that movie, didn't you?
We tried to watch, but we couldn't finish.
Okay.
Yeah, we only got a few minutes through. And
well, next time you can watch more. And then here we have the 30th of April.
Hmm, that was an interesting day.
And then on the 1st of May... Peter, what happened on that day?
I don't remember.
Oh, Peter Rabbit was on DVD the first of the month. I watched that film, and, you know, it's Peter Rabbit-y. Mm-hmm. It wasn't as mean as I thought it was from the preview. And then May the 4th be with you. If you get the joke. Yeah, people call it Star Wars Day. It's a huge celebration that I don't even know what people do on that day. But then there's a bunch of days that just go by. Oh, here's books. The 49th Mystic and a Stephen R. Lawhead book in store. The 49th Mystic, which I need to italicize, is a Ted Decker book from the series of The Circle, which Miranda hates. Not the same Circle as the one that was made into a movie that Central Casting called me for, but was too far away for me to make it to the destination. The one with Emma Watson and Tom Hanks. Central Casting actually called me for that one, but I guess I couldn't make it to the destination or something. So I could have been in the background for that, and I'd be all prideful.
Yep. You didn't get to go.
Yeah, that would have been. And I still have not been in a movie, other than on the Spider-Man Homecoming DVD, in the preview for the Goldbergs. But The Circle by Ted Decker, that series. Black, red, white, and green. And then here's Black Panther on DVD. I bought it on DVD and still haven't seen it on DVD because I've been busy. But you saw it, right?
Yeah, it seems like most others.
Oh, okay. But yeah, I got that on DVD.
It seems special.
Oh, well, I still haven't seen my copy of the DVD because, you know, it was getting close to finals and I needed to do my work and I was, like, all busy and stuff. And I just wasn't able to sit back and relax and enjoy it at that point. And then The Early Man on DVD. I still got to put this on hold, but last time I tried, it wasn't letting me put it on hold at the library here. And so, yeah, that's just the way it is. So that didn't get on hold yet. And then Solo in theaters! He doesn't look much like Han Solo, and I don't...
Who, me?
No, that guy in the movie. I mean, he looks like maybe he could be a brother. Like, there are some things that look the same, but he just doesn't look like Han Solo for some reason. And to me, it just... I don't know. I don't want the Han Solo we all know and love to be created from plastic surgery. That's the only way I can think of that those two characters could be the same. And if there was a larger age difference, it probably would have been fine, but yeah. So, the reason I didn't feel like seeing this in theaters is unrelated to how I felt about Star Wars 8, because this is a spinoff, and so, you know, it probably, you know, it's not a follow-up, which, you know, they just overwrote the exciting books to make the underwhelming follow-ups. Yes, I'm being terrible. That's how I felt. This is not necessarily how you felt. If you enjoyed the Star Wars sequel, that's fine with me. I just felt they were underwhelming and that they should just be a possible future, not the only future to the originals. And, you know, it was just... But that's not the reason I didn't see Solo. It just, he doesn't look like Han Solo. And I think it's pretty cool that Opie directed that film. But, yeah. Here was a birthday. And then here was Memorial Day. And then, here was another birthday.
That was a hard day.
Why? And then a bunch of other days that had nothing. And so that was pretty much May. And I did not put Deadpool 2 on here. I wonder why. Yeah, because I don't see R-rated films. Sorry. Yep, I'm being very rude, aren't I? And next month's theme. Do you know what next month's theme is?
Maybe.
Oh yeah, I probably revealed it too much. Avatar the Last Airbender, Book 3, Fire! Oh, and by the way, if you look up Book 3, Fire online, you'll get Wings of Fire 3 also.
Yep. I really like that series.
I do.
You read all the time.
And so,
to be lonely.
Here is my May 2018 calendar. I hope you enjoyed. Okay, bye. Thanks. As you head off to the war, pick a star on the dark horizon and follow the light. You'll come back when it's over. No need to say goodbye. You'll come back when it's over. No need to say goodbye.
To say goodbye.